My mother used to say, birds of a feather flock together. If you run around with losers, you will end up a loser. It's necessary that you get the losers out of your life if you want to live your dream.
Myself. That's necessary.
Commitment. That word that a lot of people don't like. Because when you talk about commitment, you know, people always try to put in a little escape clause with commitment. And so you say, are you committed? And so by asking a person, are they committed to something, you're basically saying, are you all in? You know, are you going to give everything you got? Are you going to eliminate excuses? And what commitment is staying true to what you said you were going to do long after the feeling has left. And people always say, well, I'll try. I'll see what I can do. And that's that escape clause. Because they know once you say you're committed, you're creating a certain level of accountability to yourself. You're creating a certain level of accountability to the thing that you're supposedly committed to. That's why when I always talk to people, And I talk to football players, and I talk to corporate company, and I talk to, you know, churches, and I talk to students. And, you know, when I talk to football players in particular, you know, I go into the team room sometimes and I ask them about, you know, their team goals and, you know, their dreams and what they want to do as a team. And so they're sitting in the team room, meaning they're sitting in AC and they're sitting in these seats, and these seats are plushed out. They got their feet kicked up and they're comfortable, and they're spitting off goals, they're spitting off dreams, they're laughing, they're having a great time. There's nothing wrong with that. But I can't tell in that moment if they're really committed. I can't tell if they're committed until the pressure hits. I go back in two-a-days, or I go back in summer camp, and that's when I will really see if they're committed, when they're tired, when their body is beat up, and see if they're coming out every day and still giving everything they got. It happens in business. People start in business, they have these goals, have these dreams, they have these high aspirations to do all these great things, and they get up day after day and life punches them in the face. And life looks at them every day and punches them in the face and say, I'm gonna hit you in your face every day and see how bad you want it. And I'm gonna see if you're committed to what you said you were going to do. I'm gonna see how bad you really want it. And until you stop, and until you show that life that you're committed to what you said you were going to do, until you face life and say, man, you're not gonna break me. I'm committed to this thing. I'm all in. Regardless of how bad it gets, regardless of how much adversity I run into, regardless of the things that come my way, the opposition, the trial, the tribulation, I'm going to use all of this to make me a stronger individual. And not only make me stronger, I am going to use every single bit of this and pour it back into the world for something positive to help other people. Because I'm committed. I'm all in everything that I do. Regardless of if it's hot, regardless of if it's cold, regardless of if it's hard, regardless of if it's easy, I'm committed. I'm committed from the start. It makes it a lot easier when you make up in your mind before you start something. When you go into that thing with that mindset of a Navy SEAL, man. A Navy SEAL, so cold-blooded, they make up in their mind before the mission that they were going to complete the mission. You make up in your mind before the mission that you are going to complete the mission. Meaning whatever happens along the way, if it does not kill you, you should not stop and you should not give up. You see, the thing you have to understand about life is two things in life. You got results and you got reasons. Reasons don't count. You know, people use reasons all the time of why they can't do something or why they shouldn't go on to accomplish things. Reasons are like excuses. But results, people respect results. But results happen by commitment. And with commitment comes discipline. And with discipline comes execution. And with execution comes results. Be committed. Don't cheat yourself. Have a certain level of accountability to yourself. Hold yourself to a higher expectation than what anybody else expects of you. Commitment is staying true to what you said you were going to do long after the feeling has left. Not what anybody else said. Commitment is staying true to what you said you were going to do. Have to remember that. You said you wanted it. You said you wanted success. You said you wanted to be the best. You said you wanted to be great. You said you wanted to be legendary. So you have to be willing to accept whatever comes with that. Stay committed. Do what others won't so you can have the results that others don't. Do what others won't so you can have the results that others don't. You see, more times than not, people raise and people lower their expectations depending upon what someone else is doing. Never being cognizant of the fact that other people's situations are totally different from yours. When I was growing up and I had this little cousin by the name of Lando. You know, he was a great athlete. You know, he was about 2 years younger than me, and, you know, we used to work out. And so he noticed that I would always do more than everybody else. If everybody was running 10 sprints, I'd run 20. If everybody was shooting 50 shots on the basketball court, I'd shoot 150 shots. Because I was raised to work to separate, not work to stay with the pack. Inc., you work to separate. You work to separate from everybody else. You want to be stronger than everybody else. When everybody else is getting tired, you want your second wind to be kicking in. And so I work to separate. And so one day he said, Inc., why don't you do what everybody else do? He said, why don't you? He said, everybody is done and you're still running. Everybody is done shooting and you're still shooting. Why don't you just shut it down like everybody else and do what's required? I said, first and foremost, when work is required, you're supposed to do that. That's why it's required. But I said, secondly, I said, our situation at home is totally different from these people. I said, you never know. The people that's out there running 10 sprints, their mother or their father may own a company. And so regardless of what they do, they may have a job. They may be set up for a lifetime. They may be able to inherit something, or somebody may take care of them. Our situation at home is totally different. We're sleeping on the floor. We're living in a two-bedroom home. It's 14 of us. When we got the opportunity to sleep in the bed, there were six of us in the bed, three at the foot, three at the head. We miss meals some nights. And so I have to work harder because I know what our situation is back at home. And so I'm not raising and I'm not lowering my standards based upon what somebody else is doing. I do what others don't so I can have results that others won't. Work to separate. Challenge yourself. I challenge you to raise yourself to a higher expectation than what anybody else expects of you. Hold yourself accountable, because at the end of the day, this thing called life, the battles and the challenges and the adversity and the opposition that you face is won by you and you, not anybody else. So when you look in that mirror at night, you have to be able to lay down and go to sleep and say, man, you know what? I emptied my bucket. Challenge yourself. I do what others don't. I do what others don't. I do what others don't. I do what others don't.